Hello YouTube, this is Tiki Bomber here, and while normally I'm doing my own things with my political videos, I actually wanted to do something a little different this time because of, you know, flavor and variety and stuff. Today's song is brought to us by No Copyright Sounds, and it is an Electrolyte song called Symbolism. So I will post the description for this video in the link for this video music in the description below. What I wanted to tackle real fast, I'm gonna make this really short, is I wanted to tackle the whole Pokemon theory about Pokemon Sun and Moon and how Ash is actually supposed to be 11 now to take the trials. The problem is, he hasn't even started his trials yet. Furthermore, by technicality, outside of the years that he's been running around and stuff like that, Ash would have to be at least 16 because he was in Unova traveling around with Iris and that gym leader, I can't remember his name. Anyways, he was traveling around with them for a good long time before he went off to Kalos, and the thing with that region, with the Unova region, you have to be at least 16 before you start your journey. That was the whole shebang for the first for Pokemon Black and Pokemon White, as well as Black 2 and White 2, is that you actually were 16. You were not 10, like it is for the rest of the world. You're not 11, like it is in Pokemon Sun and Moon, but you were 16. So if we go off of that, then yeah, Ash would be over 16 at the very least, but at the same time, he's also not 16 in Alola. And I think the Pokemon theories, the multiverse theory, comes well into play for this. And they love to use the multi-theory in general to kind of cover all their bases. So when we see Ash traveling around, we're actually seeing multiple Ashes with the same Pikachu, same personality in these different regions traveling around. Especially when it comes to things like Unova and Alola. Because there's no way he could be 16 for one and 11 for the other. Go ahead and give me any thoughts and ideas about that. I'm gonna try and have another video up as soon as possible. Something that's gonna go back into my normal roots. I'm just throwing my ideas out there right now for you guys. I recently did a 200 video. So if you have not had a chance to go and watch that 200 sub video, thank you. Feel free to do so. Unless you're not into that kind of thing, then that's fine. You can still listen to it though. Play it in the background or something, because, you know, I do these videos for fun. I do these videos because they're fun. It's a great way to de-stress and all this stuff. I don't make any money off of these videos. I do have Patreon listed in my description below, but I also do not constantly ask people to become a patron. I don't ask you guys to sub to me. I don't ask you guys to like my videos. I don't do this because, you know, this is for me. This is just me to unwind and stuff like that. So yeah, there's that going on as well. Anything that you want to find is going to be in the description below. My thoughts out there. What do you think about the multi-theory for Pokemon anime being applied as well as the Pokemon video games? Because they do have the multi-theory in the video games. I know that for sure. And, you know, go check out my other links. Definitely check out my Twitter. I mainly retweet other people's crap all the time, or I will sit there and yell at Google for having a 16 gig phone and 15 of its 16 gigs are already used by Google apps that I don't use at all. Until next time, this is Tiki Bomber signing out. Peace.